Hi everybody, I'm Dr. Kohila, Anatomy faculty. In this presentation, you're going to see about Level 1 Anatomy MCQs available in our Concept app. I'll read this case scenario for you. A 22-year-old female was referred to emergency room after a fall from height on an outstretched left wrist. Pain and tenderness were noticed in the region of anatomical snuff box of her left hand. X-ray showed fracture of scaphoid bone. You can see the X-ray image here. The yellow arrows pointing towards the fractured scaphoid bone. The question is, identify the correct statement. Option A, fracture of scaphoid has a low incidence of non-union. Option B, scaphoid bone articulates with 5 bones totally. Option C, scaphoid bone can be easily immobilized. Option D, fracture line on the scaphoid bone deprives the distal fragment of its arterial supply. Which one do you think is the correct answer? So before we move on to the correct answer, we'll have a quick discussion about the anatomy of scaphoid bone. So the scaphoid bone is called so because it is boat-shaped. Where is it located? The scaphoid bone contributes to the proximal row of carpal bone, isn't it? How to differentiate between whether the scaphoid is left side or right side? By the presence of this tubercle. You can see something projecting out here. Okay, that's called the tubercle of the scaphoid. It is present on the lateral aspect distally. Got it? Okay. So the tubercle of the scaphoid is the important characteristic feature to identify whether the scaphoid is left side or right side. Now, my question is, can any of you tell me the attachments to the lateral tubercle? If you know the answer, please enter in the comment box. In this image, you get to see the wrist joint, the carpal bones, the metacarpal bones. This is a scaphoid. Okay. Now, how many bones are going to articulate with the scaphoid? So, the scaphoid, I told you, it forms the proximal row, boat shape. Okay. Now, the scaphoid is going to articulate with the radius, proximally, distally, it articulates with the trapezium, trapezoid, medially it articulates with capitate and lunate. Okay, so totally there are 5 bones which are going to articulate with the scaphoid. The most interesting feature of the scaphoid bone is its blood supply. The main source of blood supply to the scaphoid bone is the radial artery. Okay. Remember, the patient had pain and tenderness over the anatomical snuff box. What is the relation of the scaphoid to the anatomical snuff box? It forms the floor, isn't it? Okay, so the radial artery, as you see here, you can see the radial artery here. Yeah, so this is the superficial palma branch of the radial artery that goes above the flexor retinaculum. That's the main trunk of the radial artery. Okay, it's going to enter the anatomical snuff box. Now, branches from the radial artery, they enter the scaphoid bone through its distal segment. Okay, so this entire thing is the scaphoid. This is the proximal part where it articulates with the radius. That's the distal end where it articulates with the trapezium. Okay, now the blood vessels, they enter the scaphoid through the distal segment. Can you see this constricted portion of the scaphoid here? That's called the waist or the neck of scaphoid. This is the waist of the scaphoid, okay? So among the carpal bones, scaphoid is the frequently fractured carpal bone. And in the scaphoid, the waist is the fractured segment, okay? That's the frequently fractured segment of the scaphoid. When there's fracture to the waist of the scaphoid, okay, the proximal segment is devoid of blood supply and it undergoes avascular necrosis. Got it? Now, coming to the discussion of the options, option A is incorrect because fracture of the scaphoid bone has high incidence of non-union. Option C, the carpal bones on the whole is very small. The capitate is the largest of the carpal bone. Since the scaphoid bone is smaller in size, it is a bit difficult to immobilize the scaphoid. Option D, we have seen that the blood vessels enter through the distal end of the scaphoid. Hence, the proximal segment will undergo avascular necrosis. Option B is the right answer. We'll take it, okay? Yeah. Because the scaphoid bone is going to articulate with 5 bones, I've told you. Radius, trapezium, trapezoid, the capitate and lunate. Okay? Yeah. I've got one more question for you. We saw the branches of the radial artery enter through the distal end of scaphoid. Now, where is the nutrient foramen for scaphoid located? Okay? If you know the answers, please enter it in the comment section. Do remember to subscribe Concept YouTube channel and also download our Concept app from the Play Store. Hope this presentation was useful. Give your feedbacks. Thank you.